myself Mahesh from 3rd Sem CSE branch. So today my topic for presentation is electoral processes in India. So India is the largest democratic country in the world, and Article 324 to Article 329 of our Constitution of India deals with about elections. So first of all, we need to go through the two terms in the electoral process. One is electoral system, and second one is election commission. So electoral system is also known as voting system. Basically, in electoral system, a set of rules and regulations and that determines elections and also conduct and how to their relatives and democratic determine. Electoral system are used in the politics to elect the government. So second one is election commission. So it is an organization that deals with the conduction of election. It consists of one chief election officer and second one is two election commission officer appointed by the President of India. Each state has one chief electoral officer. Each constituency should have an election registration officer. So what are the functions of election commission of this? So it conducts the election, first of all, and in preparation of electoral roll, second one. So electoral roll is the voter ID which will provide by majority of the people who are above 18 people, and prescribing the qualification of MPs, MLAs and MCQs. One is types of elections. There are basically four types of elections. One is general election, midterm election, pre-election and by-election. So general elections consist of every 5 years once for both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Second one is midterm election. Due to government dissolved or party dissolution, midterm elections will be targeted. Re-elections, like irregularities in the elections and bribing and threatening of the candidate, re-elections will be conducted. And last one is by-election. By-elections are conducted due to the death or resignation of the present member. Basically, election process in India is notification of election by the president for the Lok Sabha and governor for the state legislative. Second was notification by election commission regarding filing the nomination withdrawal. Third one is filling of nomination papers like B form and depository amount. Note the depository amount is collected from the candidate to reduce the entries, not just for entering but also by reducing the fake entering of the election. Notification and expectations of the rejection of nomination papers. Fifth one is election campaigning. Note the election campaigning should be stopped before 36 hours before the polling booth. And next step is polling process. And the final step, counting of votes and announcement of the result. Here I identify the topic electoral process in India. These are the steps which are undertaken by the election commission during the election process. Thank you.